What's going on YouTube? It's Dizzini. Welcome to a brand new video. Today I got a Diag one for y'all. 2013 Dodge Journey that came in on a tow truck. No crank, no start. Dead battery. Crank, no start. And then, so pretty much show y'all from that process how I came to the conclusion of what was wrong. Repaired it. Show you, verified my repair. Now, you're going to see me do some steps that are probably unnecessary or kind of jump around. That's just because I'm showing you how I actually straight up went about this vehicle. Not South Main Auto, Scanner Danner, Super Mario, Pine Hollow. I'm not on their top tier level. So when it comes to diagging and thinking, I consider myself a novice, just a certified parts changer. You know what I mean? So anyways, check out this video and I'll get back to you afterwards.
Dodge Journey 2013, no crank, no start, complete dead battery, jump box, crank, no start. So hopefully see if I can get some codes real quick. I don't know, it's cranking, got fuel pressure. See, maybe that crank sensor or something. I don't know, I feel like it's not getting spark or something. I want to do a quick test. I'm going to check engine RPM. See if I see anything real quick. See if I got any codes. Go from there. Using the auto fix. It's hot out here. And of course, no codes detected. So I'm going to go to live data real quick. I want to check engine RPM. So a little tech tip there. Can't say it's always 100% accurate, but if I see zero RPMs while it's cranking, it kind of gives me a sign to let's check out what's going on with the crank signal. Now, just because you see RPMs and live data doesn't necessarily mean you don't have a random dropout with the crank sensor, obviously. And you can see it's taking some time, so I'm gonna let it load up. Oh, there it goes. Let's see, I can actually, where's the search button? Did have a search button. Oh, there it is. Let's just go RPM. I don't like that it does that. So gotta do engine speed. I'll graph this. Make that full screen. And let's see if we get something. Let's go back. What happened? Alright, let's do this again. You can see zero up top and you'll see the graphing here. I didn't see anything, but got you zoomed in. I don't know if you can hear it. It sounds ugly. No RPMs, so this gives me some sign of direction, I feel. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get the battery charge on here, get the battery charged up, and crawl underneath real quick to make sure I didn't see a hole in the block. I didn't notice oil. I mean, I have seen it before where it sounds fine, finally get it started, and then fucking big old loud knock, so. Checked real quick. So what I'm gonna do real quick, because it's easy, I got cam sensors here. I'm gonna back probe into them, check some wiring diagrams real quick. It's obviously gonna be one or the other wire, and just verify things are turning and the insides are good, and go from there without pulling a valve cover or anything. Honestly, you could probably do this. Let's see. Yeah, no, you can't see in there. Okay. Some cars you can actually see the camshaft. So I'm gonna go get my scope, use scope real quick, back probe to one of these cam sensors, crank it, see if I get any signal. That way it at least tells me it's rotating, the engine is actually turning inside mechanically. So like,
all right, it's actually a three wire, so
blue wires, my sensor, 5-volt reference, and my ground. Check all three. Then I'll check my signal, crankshaft. Okay. All right, so I'm actually gonna check at the crankshaft. Got it unplugged. So I'm gonna pierce this here, plug it back in,
nice
and
there,
get a signal. So I know I said I'll check the cam, wanna go straight to the crankshaft, but you know, just how I did it, how I approached it, not scanner down or whatever. So went to the crank sensor. I was able to actually bend the heat shield out of the way. Vehicle's cold, so I'm not gonna be burning my hand. Reach my arm down there. I unplugged the wire so I can strip down the wire loom. And right now I am pierced on the 5-volt reference. So you can see I have 5-volt reference. I got ground, so I'm gonna move it to the brown wire, which is my signal wire, and show you that I don't have any signal. And for me, I'm gonna call a crank signal and a crank sensor, and then we'll retest and see if this thing starts. All right, now if you can see, I am on the brown wire back there. I get my scope around to the car, the inside. All right, let's crank this bad boy. And nothing. Can you even check? All right, into the brown wire.
Nada. That's good. Okay, do a multi-point inspection either way.
Okay. It's gonna start right up. Like shit, but started. Got crank signal. All right, I didn't show me putting the new crank sensor in. I got a new crank sensor in. Showed you the piercing. These do have a crank relearn, so I'm gonna let it run right now because it is idling funny. Help recharge that battery some more, get it pulled in so I can do a inspection, relearn the throttle, relearn the crank sensor, and yeah, we're done. No crank, no start, bad cam, bad crank sensor. All right, gonna do the cam crank relearn. It keeps stalling, but it's starting, so. Busted out my launch so I can do the cam crank relearn. Some reason the auto fix, when it would get to that, it would just stay in the loading screen. And I don't know. So I got my launch. Now the procedure's done. And of course, I'm pretty sure I have to say, because there is people out there, pierced it. Yes, I'm gonna put some nail polish actually on there and get them sealed up. And this thing said a check engine light pretty fast for low oil pressure, dipsticks not marking. Get some oil on this thing so I can run it later.
Also, so there's my Diag video. I know the audio is kind of wishy-washy. I was inside, outside. I'll figure it out as I go and make more videos. I do apologize, but hopefully you did learn something, learn some tips or tricks. Like again, I'm a beginner to this. I consider myself a novice, entry-level diagnostics. I'm learning, and hopefully you learned something too. Anyways, if you like the video, give me a thumbs up. Got any questions or concerns or comments of what I did or why, leave a comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell to get notified when I post another video. Follow me on Instagram. I'm pretty active on there at It's Dezini. Put a link down below. As always, stay slutty, and that's about it. See ya.